We're coming to you live from Paris. This is Go for Glory, but unfortunately, no great news to report from here after what has happened with Vinesh Fogat. We were all prepping up to be gearing up for her bout, which was going to be a gold medal bout that she would have been participating in today, but that is not to be after the weighing-in that happened this morning, where she was found to be just 100 grams overweight. After that, she had a bit of an incident where she was dehydrated. She was admitted to the local hospital here inside the Games Village. That's exactly where we're coming to you live from. But the latest image that we are showing you right now is of Vinesh Fogat, who is looking fit. She's of course looking distraught, as you can see on the screen right now. She is clearly not in the frame of mind that she would have been otherwise had she been playing the final. But also what you can see in those pictures are hair. Remember her fighting those previous three rounds with hair up until her shoulders. Now you can see her in really short hair right now, which also tells you that every little effort that they could make to ensure that she loses that last bit of weight actually went in vain, and it wasn't possible to have her under the 50 kilogram category that she was participating in. It tends to happen. Just to let you know, she had gained about 2.7 kilos over the period of Tuesday. Remember, on Tuesday morning when she was weighing in, she was sub 50 kilograms, and over the course of her three bouts, because she was replenishing the salts in her body, the water in her body, the food that she needed at that time, by the end of the day she had gained about 2.7 kilos. That proved to be next to impossible for her to cut down come the day of the final. Let's look at that entire story and how that panned out.
Vinesh Fogat was on her way to creating history at the Paris Olympics. But just hours later, her dream was shattered as she was disqualified from the gold medal bout. The wrestler had defeated reigning Olympic 50 kg champion Yui Suzuki on her road to the final. In the semi-final, she had outclassed Cuba's Yuslenis Guzman 5-0 to assure at least a silver. However, on the morning of the final, Vinesh missed the weight cut by a little over 100 grams that led to her disqualification. The 29-year-old's campaign came to a morale-shattering halt as she was eliminated ahead of the final. Vinesh and her support staff tried everything, including extreme measures like cutting her hair and attempting to draw out blood, but all their efforts went to no avail.
In the morning, we found that despite all of our efforts, her weight was 100 grams over her 50 kilogram weight category, and hence she was disqualified. We had tried all possible drastic measures throughout the night, including cutting off her hair, shortening her clothes. And despite all of this, we could not make that 50 kg weight category.
The rules are very clear when it comes to such situations. If an athlete does not attend or fails the weigh-in, he or she will be eliminated from the competition and ranked last without a ranking. India have lodged a protest, and the Wrestling Federation chief has vowed to take up the matter with the highest authorities.
उम्मीद पे तो हम टिके हैं और अभी हम लड़ रहे हैं. मैं तो अंतिम दम तक प्रयास करूंगा कि ये मेडल हम किसी भी तरह से मुझे फाइट का मौका मिल जाए और मेडल हिंदुस्तान की झोली में डालवा सकूं.
The Olympics, which is the highlight of an athlete's career, has never left happy memories for Vinesh Fogat. In Paris, her perfect redemption story was just one chapter away, but in a sheer anti-climax, Vinesh has been denied a place in history. Sports Bureau, India Today.
Now, the way this story has been unfolding, I'm sure a lot of you have plenty of questions on your mind. What we're going to try and do for the next couple of minutes is really break down this entire fiasco, this controversy that has erupted here, and breaking down by answering
the most frequently asked questions, the FAQs that are on the mind of all sporting fans, in fact, by just sporting fans all across India that had been glued to Vinesh's fight yesterday and were interested to see her gold medal bout today. Here are the most commonly asked questions and our answers to each one of them. The first one, of course, that everyone is asking, could Vinesh have skipped weigh-in by faking an injury? Okay, so, you know, many are saying that, listen, she had already reached the final. If she had pulled out of the final without going in for the weighing-in because she knew she was 100 grams overweight, they would have to give her a silver medal because she would have given a bye. The answer to that is no, she couldn't have done that. So this is an idea or an option that isn't new, it isn't unique. This is something that the Indian camp also explored. They thought about it, but you cannot do it because the rules clearly suggest that even if you are deciding to pull out, let's say because of fever, because of an injury, you have to come in for the weigh-in. You weigh in, if you're found within the 50 kilogram category in which she was participating, then fine, you can pull out and then you get the silver medal. So at no point could this strategy have been employed by Vinesh and her team, that she pulls out knowing fully well that she might be overweight and then at least ends up with a bronze medal. So that is the first question answer, the first frequently asked question about this entire fiasco. The next question that everyone is asking, could she have cut hair or drained her blood to lose weight? Well, tell you what, let's start with the first option that people are saying, because you saw her fighting with hair about till her shoulder length. Could she have cut it really short and then competed? The answer to that question is something that we gave right at the top of the show when we showed you her latest picture from the hospital bed, which is right on my left at the moment, which is where the Olympic Village is. She is being admitted there. You saw her latest picture. So they did cut her hair. So they cut her hair as short as, you know, my hair at the moment. So as short as they could to ensure that even those few grams could have been taken care of. But unfortunately, even that could not happen. So far as draining blood is concerned, that wasn't an option. You cannot be doing it because remember, she's an athlete. She's competing. She's anyway really starved for food. She's only had one meal over a period of almost 40 hours while she's competed, and she would be competing in the final. So with all that in mind, this is not something that they could have done. So this is another option that could not have been exercised, and some of it was, but really did not help. The next big question to which everyone is looking for an answer to is, did Vinesh's support staff botch up? And whatever we are getting to hear at the moment, the answer to that would be a partial yes. Because they knew this was the scenario. They knew for the last few months she has been participating in 50 kilogram category, a weight category that is much less than her natural weight. She went to the Olympic qualifiers as well, where she had to drastically cut her weight down. So this is an exercise that they have been following for the last few months. Agreed that for a 57, 58 natural weight category player to drop down to 50, about 7, 8 kilos, is not easy. Agreed. But it's not something that they hadn't done before. And they faltered at the most important part, which is just before her final. The team did try. She ran off as soon as she finished her final bout last night. She ran off to start doing her skipping, sweating, sauna, cycling, various other things, just cutting off water and everything to bring her weight down, which had gone to 52.7, but it could not be achieved. What we're getting to know now from the wrestling federation is that they're going to order an inquiry, look into it, that why this could not be managed. But to let you know that the medical staff here, we heard from Dr. Pardiwala as well, where he said everything that you can think of medically, everything that you can think of was done. If you had gone a step further to try and do more drastic issues, then she wouldn't have been fit enough even to stand. And they could not risk something like that. So that's another question that has been answered in terms of the most commonly asked questions now that Vinesh is not going to be fighting her final. The next one is, should Vinesh have been given a silver since weight was in check earlier? And that's a tricky one. That's a very interesting one. Because remember, day one when she fought, She was within the 50 kilogram category and she won her three bouts fair and square and she reached the final. So many are arguing, okay, fine. On the day of the final, she's not with the weight category. Don't allow her to compete with the final, but don't take away the medal that she had won earlier because of, you know, her winning those crucial encounters. The answer to that is the rules are pretty clear. This was mentioned earlier. And by the way, these aren't new rules. These rules were put into place way back in 2013. So it's been 11 years since these rules have been in play that over a period of 2 days, you have to be in the weight category, which is the one that you're participating in it. And if you cannot, then these steps will be taken. So on that count as well, no wrongdoing. They just followed exactly what they were supposed to do. And the final most commonly asked question is, can disqualification be overturned following an appeal? The answer to that, unfortunately, at the moment is no. The decision now cannot be overturned. We already know the final. It's between the Cuban, the one that Vinish beat in the semifinal, between her and the finalist that is going to be from the USA. That's decided. Vinish will be classified last. The rules are in place. We've done an interview with the UWW chief as well. He's made it very clear that nothing can be done at the moment. See, whenever there's an issue in terms of refereeing standard or there is an issue in terms of you're not happy with the kind of points that are given, then maybe you can file an appeal and that can be looked at because there is ambiguity there. But in this case, what they're saying, it's a case of black and white, and in a case of black and white, there's nothing more that can be done. Let's listen in to Dr. Pardiwala, who will explain a bit more in terms of what really happened, what are the things that they tried, and where is it that the Indian team faltered.
Her post-participation weight at the end of the semi-finals in the evening was found to be 2.7 kilograms more than the allowed weight. And the team and the coach started off their usual process, which is, of course, limitation of water, no food, and you started with the whole process of sweating it out. And typically, you know, you require some amount of time for that, but unfortunately, we didn't have too much time. We had just 12 hours. So the whole night, the entire team, you know, went ahead with this whole process of trying to reduce her weight, putting her in a steam and sauna, making her exercise, and whatever was medically possible, we, you know, we tried our best to try and get that weight down. At about 7:15 to 7:30 is the weigh-in, and we wanted to try the best, so we got her weight done right at the end at around 7:29. It was unfortunately 100 grams over 50 kilograms. If we maybe had a few hours more, we could have achieved that 100 grams, but we just didn't have that time.
Okay, we are also joined live by Dr. Narendra Batra, the former IOA chief. Dr. Batra, first up, you know, in terms of the administration, do you think something more could have been done? Are you happy with the kind of efforts that the people here, that would include the chef de mission, the IOA chief, the doctors, the kind of steps that they've taken, are there enough? Or do you think something more could have been done to salvage the situation?
No, I believe the normal hai when you go for the wrestling bouts in a weight category, the weight does fluctuate and it's normal to get their weight reduced. Now, what happened in this particular case, I cannot comment on it. Like I heard Dr. Pardiwala say that if they had more couple of hours, they could have managed it. So what happened, I have no idea, but I won't blame any administration or any IOA president or anyone for it. This is standard. It happens in all categories where you have weight restrictions. So there's nothing new in it.
Do you reckon, Dr. Batra, that the situation could have been slightly better managed in terms of, you know, giving Vinesh that weight category? Remember, 53 kilogram category was her favored weight category. She was forced to participate in 50 simply because you had to accommodate Antim in the 53 kilogram category, who's played about and lost in the first round.
I don't know whether she was forced or not. No one goes into a forced category. If she chose 50 categories, weight category, then she should have made sure that she stays within that. But I don't think we should be discussing on that. It's a very sad thing that a woman who qualified first time now is coming back without a medal. And we should see that these things don't happen. This has happened earlier also. In Asian Games, Sushil was disqualified before even the first round was played. He was over by 40 grams. So this is nothing new. This should have been taken care of, but That's it. That's how the life goes on.
So you, as you said, then who would be held responsible if it's not the IOA, if it's not going to be the athlete for choosing a different weight category? You're saying it should not happen going forward. What should be done that it doesn't happen?
No. The people who should be asked is the four people who were with her, her coach, her nutritionist, and I believe there were two other people, there were four people who were allowed with her. The weight should have been, because she played three bouts yesterday. And between every bout to hydrate her and to give her energy, things she must have eaten and taken liquids and everything. So the weight monitoring should have been happening throughout. And in these events, when the events are back-to-back the next day, you normally have those things which actually pass out of the body in liquid form pretty quick. So I don't know what kind of diet was given and things which may have gone into the muscle area or somewhere where the weights could not have gone out. So I don't know. It's very difficult for me to comment until the doctor has the medical reports or blood reports on which are the levels which went high. So I have no idea. It's very difficult for me to comment right now.
Okay, let's listen in to the exclusive that we've done with the UWW chief, which of course stands for United World Wrestling, the governing body, which has of course framed the rules based on which Vinesh Fogat has been knocked out. I spoke to him a short while ago, and this is what he had to say.
Sir, what would you have to say about Vinesh's unfortunate removal from this competition?
We have to respect the rules. I'm so sad that what happened to her. She had overweight, a very small one, but the rules are rules, and the weigh-in is public. All the athletes are there, and it's impossible to let someone to compete who doesn't make the weight.
People are saying that she made the weight on day one and reached the final. If day two she did not, maybe disqualify her from the final but allow her to get that medal because she won fair and square in the first few games?
Impossible. Because the brackets are changing, everything is changing. And the rules are rules. Everybody who goes to this continues, they know they have a second weigh-in the next day.
There has been an appeal. Can anything be done right now?
I don't see anything that can be done. The competition continues, and I really don't see that it's possible.
Okay, we heard from the boss of the World Wrestling Federation saying nothing much can be done now as the situation stands. It's done and dusted for Vinesh Fogat. She'll have to go back empty-handed despite the fact that she had qualified for the final. We heard from Narendra Batra, the former IOA chief. He says that questions need to be asked of the support staff. She has a four-member support staff. Why is it that, you know, they could not get things into place? And these are the big questions that we are also asking in our show today. Did the support staff not foresee the weight gain? That is the first bit, and the answer to that is that she had gained about 2.7 kilos after her first round. So did the support staff not foresee that? Had it not happened before? She's been competing in this weight category for some time, so this is something that they should have been prepared for. Second question, and the big question, was there an error in judgment in terms of the techniques that were employed to ensure that she loses that 2.7 kilos that she had gained extra? Could other things have been done? Better solutions have been found so that she comes within the required weight category. The third big question we are asking, was there a change in Vinesh's prescribed diet? She has been under the 50 kilogram category, competing for the last few months, qualified for the Olympics in that category by winning an Olympic quota during qualification, Asian qualifications. Did you change her diet at the last moment? Is that why the slip up happened? And the fourth big question that we are asking on our broadcast, were all options explored by the support staff? Could they have done something different on the eve of the game and ensured that Vinesh is ready for that final? So these are the four big questions that we are asking on our broadcast. Narendra Batra, the IOA chief, is still with us. Do you reckon, sir, some of these questions that I've raised, somewhere amongst these questions, whether it was the diet change, whether they didn't preempt it, things went wrong, and which is why Vinesh cannot compete in that final?
I think Jesse, when the first bout entered and ended and she had to go into the second bout, naturally she had to be given supplement, but weight monitoring should have been going on side by side. You cannot allow that to lapse. Then from second to third also, and what was the result after that and how you could check it from then till the morning when the new weight had to take place, this should have been monitored properly. I feel there is some lapse, otherwise these things cannot happen, that you are going into sauna, you're going into this thing. There has been some carelessness somewhere. Now, difficult for me from here to point out, but it has to be limited within those four people who were accompanying her, because the chef de mission or IOA president are not with, because they have to handle all the sports, not just one sport. So it's limited to those four people, I would say. It should be isolated to those four people.
Okay, will there then be an investigation? Will the Indian Wrestling Federation look into this entire matter? Because as Narendra Batra also pointing out there, that it's not possible for the IOA president, for the chef de mission in Gagan Narang, the IOA president in PT Usha, to look at various things. Let's listen into what the Indian Federation is saying at the moment. Do they also hold somebody responsible? And if they do, what are going to be the steps that the federation is going to take going forward to ensure? We've heard already, it has happened to Sushil Kumar once. It's happened now to Vinish Fogat. What can be done to ensure another unfortunate incident like this is not repeated in the future? I spoke to Sanjay Singh, who is the current head of the Indian Wrestling Federation.
सर, सबसे पहले तो आपकी पहली प्रतिक्रिया जानना चाहेंगे, क्योंकि मेडल तो यहाँ पक्का था।
मेडल 100% पक्का था और गोल्ड मेडल था, और यह हमारे 140 करोड़ देश की जनता का दुर्भाग्य है कि हम भारतीय कुश्ती का इतिहास बनाते बनाते रह गए।
एक सवाल अब जो जहन में आ रहा है वो ये कि काफी करीबी मामला था, 100 ग्राम कहा जा रहा है, 150 ग्राम कहा जा रहा है, जो भी है, क्या सपोर्ट स्टाफ से यहाँ सवाल नहीं खड़े होंगे? जो डाइटिशियन है,
100% ये सपोर्ट स्टाफ के का ही वो है, क्योंकि उन्हीं के खिलाड़ी तो प्रैक्टिस करने में और इसमें है, और इतनी बढ़िया परफॉर्मेंस विनेश ने दिया है, और ये इसके जिम्मेदार वही होंगे।
आपके पास कोई अभी तरीका है? क्योंकि देखिए, जो भी दर्शक हमारे देख रहे हैं उनको लग रहा है अभी भी कुछ उम्मीद है, अभी भी 6-7 घंटे बचे
हैं। अभी हम लोगों ने वहाँ मेल कर दिया है पूरे उसके साथ एक बना करके, और बाकी उस पर देखिए वो क्या कार्रवाई करते हैं, नहीं फिर आगे हम लोग अभी कैसे उसमें केस में भी जा सकते हैं।
एक चीज़ ये कही गई कि देखिए, बड़ी कोशिश की गई उनका वेट कम करने के लिए, आलम ये आ गया था यहाँ तक कि डिहाइड्रेट होके हॉस्पिटल में उन्हें रखना पड़ा, तो कोशिश पूरी की थी आप?
कोशिश पूरी कोशिश की गई कि किसी तरह से उनका वेट आ जाए, क्योंकि लास्ट 100 ग्राम पे आके वेट रुक गया, उसके बाद वेट नहीं कम हो पाया। ये हमारे देश का दुर्भाग्य है।
अभी क्या स्थिति है? क्योंकि कह रहे थे वो शायद फेंट हो गई हैं, अस्पताल में हैं।
नहीं, ऐसा कुछ नहीं। उन्होंने मेहनत किया, 5 घंटे साइकिलिंग किया, वजन कम करने के लिए सब कुछ किया, इसके लिए वो थोड़ा रेस्ट पे हैं। कोई ऐसा नहीं कि हॉस्पिटल में है, वो बीमार हो गई, ये सब बिना मतलब करे उम्र उड़ रहा है।
एक दूसरी चीज है, लोग कह रहे हैं कि पहले तो एक ही समय वेइन हुआ करता था, जब कंपटीशन स्टार्ट होता था पहले एक बार वेइन होता था, फिर आप 2 दिन खेलते थे, ये नया नियम आया है दो दिन में वेइन कर?
डेली वेइन होता है ओलंपिक में, हमेशा जब जिस दिन कुश्ती रहेगी उस दिन सुबह वजन होता है,
दोनों दिन वेइन किया जाता है। आप ये भी एक दुर्भाग्य मानते हैं कि लोग कह रहे हैं कि चलिए पहले दिन तो वेइन सही था, वो गोल्ड मेडल मैच तक तो चली गई, तो आप अगर ठीक है दूसरे दिन वेइन नहीं हुआ तो उनका सिल्वर तो कम से कम आप दीजिए जो उन्होंने इतनी मेहनत से कमाया?
अब वो अपने नियम से देंगे ना, इसके लिए हम उनको नहीं कर सकते, इसके लिए प्रेशर नहीं कर सकते। UWW, IOC और OC ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमेटी जो है ओलंपिक की, ये उनका रूल रेगुलेशन है।
अच्छा, इस बीच ये भी कह रहे थे विजेंदर सिंह जो ओलंपियन है हमारे साथ जुड़े थे, उन्होंने कहा देखिए दूसरे देश नहीं चाहते इंडिया का कुछ अच्छा हो, आपको लगता है कुछ इस तरह की कंस्पिरेसी है, कुछ देखना पड़ेगा कि भारत के खिलाफ
कुछ लोग तो है? हम दूसरे और तो नहीं कर सकते, लेकिन कुछ लोग तो हैं जो चाहते हैं जो कुश्ती का अच्छा ना हो।
नहीं, वो भारत के अंदर है या बाहर?
बाहर अंदर कहाँ है, कुछ ना कुछ तो है जिससे कि भारत की कुश्ती का मेडल ना है, कुछ तो लोग इसके लिए लगे हुए हैं।
अच्छा, जाते जाते आपसे जानना चाहूंगा, देखिए विनीश और रेसलिंग फेडरेशन के बीच जो भी अनबन रही, लेकिन जब उनका कंपटीशन था आप लोग उनके पूरे साथ थे?
बिल्कुल पूरे साथ थे। मैं उनके सेमीफाइनल कंपटीशन में अंदर था, मैं आपको टिकट भेज देता हूँ, मैं अंदर मौजूद था, सब कुछ था उनके साथ, और वहाँ बाकी लोगों से मैं हालचाल भी, उनसे मेरी बात नहीं होती है, बाकी लोगों से मैं हालचाल भी ले रहा था कि कैसे है, क्या तैयारी चल रही है, कोई सबसे पूछताछ भी चलती थी।
आखिरी में जाते जाते कुछ उम्मीद है अभी भी कुछ किया जा सकता है?
उम्मीद पे तो हम टिके हैं और अभी हम लड़ रहे हैं, मैं तो अंतिम दम तक प्रयास करूंगा कि ये मेडल हम किसी भी तरह से मुझे फाइट का मौका मिल जाए और मेडल हिंदुस्तान की झोली में डालवा सकूं।
Okay, we're coming to you live from Paris, and the big news that is emerging from that entire Vinesh Fogart controversy is that the WFI, the Wrestling Federation of India, has decided to set up a pro panel. We spoke to the chief a short while ago, where he had said exclusively to India Today that we are going to be investigating the matter, and now they have set up a pro panel to look into where is it that the botch-up really happened. They're going to investigate the support staff, four-member support staff that Vinesh was carrying with her for this competition, and where does the problem really lie is something that WFI really wants to get to the bottom of. Okay, let's now also give you a bit of a timeline as to how the entire chain of events really happened here in case of Vinesh Fogart. We'll start from Tuesday morning, that's yesterday morning. The weigh-in was done, and at that time, Vinesh weighed in at 49.9 kilograms, just enough to make it to the 50 kilogram category. After the semi-final, remember she fought three bouts on that day. After her third bout, the semi-final bout, when she weighed in, it was at 52.7, but remember, this is a private weigh-in she's doing. This is not an official one, but this is for her knowledge, how much she's weighing at the time. So she knew she was 2.7 kilos up because of the meal that she had had while she was competing at that level. And so she had to drop that 2.7 kilos overnight. What did she do overnight? She cut her hair. She apparently, as is being reported, jogged, skipped, cycled, did multiple cardio exercises to ensure that her weight does drop down. What happens then? That's the next step. That is the weighing that she does on the Wednesday morning. At the time of the weighing, it was at 7 a.m. here, Paris time. She weighs in at 50 kg, 100 grams, just about 100 grams over than the required weight that was needed. Now, after exceeding the weight limit, she got 15 more minutes to reduce the weight to the stipulated limit. They tried everything they could. She did a sauna. She tried to sweat it out. But at one point, even sweat wasn't coming out because there was no water remaining in her body. She hadn't been drinking. She was dehydrated. She tried everything, and yet she could not get inside the prescribed weight limit. And finally, she was disqualified from the final bout and subsequently hospitalized. Now, the latest is that she is fine, she's doing well. And we spoke to Manisha Malhotra, who's a former Olympian, also managed Vinesh Fogart for a very long time, looked after her trainers, her coaches for a good period of 7 to 8 years. So she knows Vinesh, her training methods inside out. Let's listen into what she has to say. Manisha, first up, I think it's a shock for the entire nation what has really happened. Could you put a few things into perspective? Firstly, could anything more have been done with what was done already to ensure that she's within the weight category?
I mean, hindsight is 20/20 always, and her weight is for her 50 was going to be difficult. So that had to be managed as soon as she decided to play 50, which I think was done. And I mean, she made 50 yesterday. She couldn't have played yesterday if she didn't make weight, right? So It's unfortunate, but the team should have been a little bit more proactive last evening.
Yeah.
Maybe kind of, understanding if weight was not getting dropped, seeing what the options could be, seeing how there was something new to be tried. I mean, I'm sure they did think about this, but I don't know.
She has her own team, she has her own coach, she has her own physio, all of it put together. I'm sure leading up to this competition, I know that even in the Olympic qualifier, she had a bit of a trouble dropping down to 50 kilograms. So their experience in that sense, obviously there is some sort of a slip up there to not being able to make that 50 kilogram category.
Yeah, of course. I mean, there is a slip up. It's 100 grams up, but those last 400 grams must have been killer. Mm. And, I was just talking to the president of the UWW saying that, listen, we need to start thinking about this. And maybe for someone in the final, there should be a 1 kilogram up or down or some sort of rule amendment. But yeah, getting back to the point, of course, now is completely not the right time to really react. It's heartbreaking. What could have been done in hindsight, or what should have been done in hindsight? Of course, I think we're going to rehash several times over, but yeah, the body just didn't react the way you wanted to. I mean, maybe she had the similar feeling the day before, and then she was able to break the 500 grams, and yesterday she was not.
Interesting you talk about speaking to the president of UWW. I mean, the one thing that most people are finding very difficult to digest is the fact that, fine, she made the 50 on day one. And if she, in that 50, has managed to reach the final, in that case, at best, you disqualify her from the final, but she still deserves a medal having reached that far in the prescribed weight category.
No, that's not the rules. The rules are very, very clear. And the rules have always been, since 2013, that you need to meet weight on both days. So, I mean, while we might like to change the rules for the future, I think that the rules are very clear for where we stand right now.
Is there any sort of recourse available? Because, you know, sometimes you appeal. I don't know for this.
They have appealed and it's not. There is no recourse to this. And it is what it is. And I don't think, I think we can, again, keep fighting. But there is not going to be any change in the result. No.